gonna transition into the game here. In the game. Nico, I was gonna ask you for some lore. Can you dabble us some lore? Give me the 411.
Give me the long and short of it. So Saati is, I don't necessarily want to like read her lore blurb, but for her, let's say the vibe is like, for her, or to you, a coin flip may be a gamble, but for her, it's an opportunity. So she is a bounty hunter, best of the best gear, best of the best skills, and what she wants, she gets. You know, she, the one line I really liked, I think, was, she may work for money, but she really makes her money work for her, and going the distance, so to speak, to make sure that she has the skills needed to, you know, essentially trounce anyone else who's coming after her marks. So she goes up against the realm's other bounty hunters, and especially as kind of bigger and bigger marks are being unveiled or rampaging around the realm. If money is no object for the people who need these things dead, then Saati's the one to call.
Yeah, don't call Ghostbusters, you know. Call Saati. She'll take your money, Saati, and get the job done. and she'll look good while doing it, and she might steal your girl. But
that's true.
But yeah, Mrs. Steal Your Girl. But with that being said, one thing that I thought was really cool that I noticed that I just wanted to just compliment the designers on, I know Alex isn't here, is I know we have a character in the game named Pip, and you guys are going to get into it here with her abilities and basic moves, but the little UI that you see near her pistol, folks, is her amount of pips. And I don't know, it just seems fitting once they describe it to you, I feel, like when I was first getting to see the character, it just made a lot of sense.
Synergy.
But yeah. Let's get into her abilities, though, Nico.
I think I'm going to start off on this one.
Go ahead.
So with her primary fire, her weapon, she's got a high-caliber semi-automatic pistol with a 7-round clip. And it's, so when you play around with it, it is high-risk, high-reward. So she reloads fairly frequently, and there's a pretty good gap in between her individual shots. Man, do they pack a punch! And if you're landing your basic attacks, you're really going to see an impact in those fights. 525 damage every half second. It's effective up to 60 units away.
Just to clarify real quick, Saati is our newest damage champion entering the game.
Good call.
Yeah, let's do it. So Saati's alt fire is called Ricochet. And Saati will flip a coin into the air that travels through the air. And the cool bit is it does deal damage if you hit enemies with it, but the fun bit, the trick shot, is if you manage to shoot it before it hits the ground, it will activate. And then subsequent shots on said coin will find their way to an enemy instead, dealing damage. The coin will be destroyed after landing 4 shots on it, after which it will explode, dealing damage in an area around it. So if you manage to get that trick shot ricochet coin in the middle of multiple enemies, shoot it a few times, get some extra chip damage, and then have it explode, that is pretty fun.
Really nice around corners, so too.
One thing I think to note about this champion is it's definitely gonna be a more, I think, not so easy character to just right off the bat be good at. Like, this is definitely gonna take, you know, I don't even want to be a pun. I don't even think it's a pun, but like it's literally like a skill shot, you know. It's just gonna take a lot of skill.
We definitely saw players in playtests start out maybe struggle a little bit, and then the more they played, the more they got into the kind of options the kit offers. I don't need to see you.
Yeah. Let's get into also her ability one, Blastback.
Sure. So this is a movement ability. She can set off a kicking backflip, hitting enemies in a 45-unit cone in front of her for 250 damage within the range, which also sets them with a damage on over time fire, and it pushes her back, importantly. So she repositions backwards, and her enemies are also knocked back up to 20 units. This consumes 4 pips and is an excellent repositioning tool. With the pip system, if you are full, you can actually get off multiple of these for some pretty extreme repositioning options.
And when speaking about that pip system, just to clarify to people, so Saati uses this pip resource, and that means that she doesn't have traditional cooldowns. So just to be clear, if you have the pips to use an ability, you can use that ability. If you don't, you can't, but there's no cooldowns for her basic abilities.
Yeah, that's actually really good to know. And for her ability number 2, yeah, we have Dead Ringer. This is probably the funniest ability, like, in the game.
Yes,
so.
This one, we're interested to see how it would turn out flavor-wise, but I think it actually turned out really well. So, Dead Ringer,
I agree.
You'll drop a facsimile of yourself on the battlefield. This is essentially a cardboard cutout with a big pistol. Fires 3 shots, or bursts of 3 shots that deal 150 damage every 1 second in a straight line. And as is tradition, since Saati starts with S, we had to, of course, that's not actually how it works, but, you know, we have to give her some stealth. So when you drop that decoy, you will gain a brief moment of invisibility, allowing you to reposition. This is fun. I have been a couple times, I've gotten pretty good about recognizing that, but I have a couple times been tricked when people have put down the Saati decoy, and I don't know where she went since I haven't bought Illuminate at that point. And then landing, or dealing damage to the decoy will reveal you to Saati very briefly, and landing a killing blow on the decoy will reveal you to Saati for, I believe it's 3 seconds, and this ability consumes 4 pips, so a little bit on the more expensive side.
Yeah, I love the decoy. The art for it in general is just hilarious, because it's super funny, but
a lot of
just
personality
in general, she is, you know, a baddie, but she also clearly likes to have fun and, you know, joke around with everyone and whatnot. So, with that being said, we can get into her ultimate here, Wallbang. I think this is, when we were in our last meeting with the AOC and showed them this, they felt like this, they liked the feeling of it. So hopefully that's the vibe that you all will get when you see it here on the stream.
In case you didn't hear also, real quick, The actual decoy says voice lines. It says, like, bang, bang, which is super fun, in my opinion. Anyway, sorry, carry on.
Really rubbing it in. Yep. Yeah. So,
yeah,
with the ultimate,
Go into wall bang.
You're going to empower your next 3 shots, which are going to be fired using your basic controls. Each one, it pierces through enemies. And it also can go through walls. So if you've got outlines from your team, or if you've used the reveal from the enemies attacking your decoy, you don't even have to have line of sight on them. And you can fire 3 massively powerful shots, each of which does 777 damage, like a lucky slot machine, to the unfortunate enemies who are hit by it.
And it can, I believe said this, but it can go through walls, right?
It absolutely does. So some really cool tactical options there.
Interesting counterplay
is,
as somebody on the opposing team, you actually do see this kind of piercing world tracer as well. So you do see it coming to some degree.
It's got some
travel
time
to it. There's some dodge capability.
Also, Strixus, on the back end there, can you throw out that Corvus spray on the wall? I don't think we got to see it yet, and it's very important.
Oh, no spray.
Oh, no joy. Oh. We'll get that sorted out for sure.
No spray, no joy. Oh! Wait, no, okay. Well, you folks can see it from the thumbnail anyways, but it's important, all right? It was me, Corvus. Anyways, those who know, No. Let me give some shout-outs, though, before we get into a little bit deeper detail here with Saati. Her concept was originally done by Thunderbrush. Abilities by 1518 Studios. Character by Mike. Weapon, Adam. Rigging, Jisoo. First-person animation, Caitlin. 3P, done by Jim. Emotes and lobby animation, Brett and Jacob. VFX, Roland. UI, Cam. Programming, Myron and Ethan. Splash art, Thunderbrush. Card art, Caravan Studios. And audio by Thomas. I think, you know, the team put a lot of love into this character. And, you know, I think it is one of our more unique champions, even though it is another, you know, every champion's going to have some kind of casting ability and whatnot, like, especially in a you know, hero shooter. And you gotta do something to make somebody with a gun, you know, be more than just a character with a gun. And I think her personality shows in her kit.
Absolutely. Really happy with how this turned out. Thanks to the whole team. And again, Alex, who did a lot of the design behind this, was not able to be here today, but really brought this together. So really happy with how this turned out.
Absolutely.
As we round out, I think, our aim section, I can talk briefly about the some of the talents and such, if we want.
Yeah, that would be great, because then we'll go into her skins right after that. So let's hear a little bit about them.
So a little bit of background info. Something that we didn't mention before is she does have a little bit of a passive as it relates to the pip system. I believe it is a slightly increased fire rate while she's above 4 pips, so 5 or greater, and then a slightly increased movement speed while she's below 5, so 4 or fewer. So just something to keep in mind as you play her. Her first talent, her default talent, is called Improvised. Her decoy is now more cost-effective to use, so the Dead Ringer decoy will cost 3 pips instead of 4, and will explode if an enemy gets close enough, dealing damage to said enemies within, I believe it's a 10-unit radius. Our level 2 talent is called Window of Opportunity. Blast Back knocks enemies straight up, and they take 20% more damage from Saati for approximately 1.5 seconds. And her level 8 talent is Heads or Tails. Ricocheted shots from the coin deal increased damage. So sorry, Strixus, I'm speedrunning these talents for you. Ricocheted shots deal 200% more damage to shields, reveal enemies for 1 second, and heal Saati for 125 HP. And as Strixus catches up here through my speedrun, my fault, friend, we will have rounded out our Saati showcase.
Absolutely, and we have some skins, as always, you know, with every new champion on release. We're going to start out, though, with her Season Pass 2021 skin, which, you know, these are always fun ones, right? Like, Ray had a really cute one. Vatu, yep, and there it is, iced out. You know, Saati is no stranger to clearly trying to have all eyes in the room on her when she walks in, right? So she's sure to catch some eyes. I love the removal of the jacket, and I like this color palette too on her. Like, it's just like a nice ivory, super clean, you know. Hopefully she doesn't get any blood on her shirt, you know, from all these bounty kills.
Be a pain to wash out, but she does her job in style.
She can definitely afford it with all the bounties she's collected.
Oh, for sure. And that skin, by the way, folks, is the one for the season pass, so only to the season pass for the iced out, and it is limited. This skin, though, is Hotshot, which is available for crystal purchase or 60,000 gold, and if you do have the season pass, this will also be automatically unlocked for you as well. And, yeah, I one thing I really like about these skins is the kind of fire theme, almost, like, we're going for with a lot of these. Like, Rey had hers where, I guess because of the cuteness factor of Rey, like, hers looked more like, you know, autumn harvesty. I think it literally is called harvest, but, Saati's here, you know, it's, red hot. And we are also going to be giving her a golden skin, which you can obtain by reaching mastery level 50. And I love the placing of the gold on the padding texture on her jacket. I think it's really fun.